Namaste students, myself Sunil Kumar from the Department of Computer Science. Today we are continuing our third session based on the chapter pointers, and today's our topic is memory allocation of pointers, pointer and structures, pointer and objects, and last topic is this pointer. In the last session we discussed about arrays and pointers. Arrays and pointer, what is the relation between the arrays and pointers? And array of pointer, it is also possible to create array of pointer. Then pointer and strings, relation between the pointer and string array or character array. Character array is known as strings. Then pointers and functions, how you can declare the functions and how you can pass the pointer as a function argument. Then pass by value method, that what we studied in last year, and pass by references, how you can pass the address. And same here, in this year we discussed about pass by pointers. Today we are moving to new topic, that is memory allocation of pointers, how you can allocate the memory to pointer. For memory allocation, there are two types of allocation are possible for a variable. One is static memory allocation and second one is dynamic allocation of memory. Static allocation of memory and dynamic allocation of memory. First we will move to the static allocation of memory. In case of static allocation of is refers to the process of allocating the memory during the compilation of the program, that is before the program executed. Remember, static memory allocation means that is reserving the space for the variables when program is compiled, or before program is compiled, or during the time of compilation. When you are going to compile the program, at that time allocating the memory means giving the some memory to the variables, allocating the memory or giving the or reserving the some memory space to a particular variable, that is done in the time of compilation, or we can say before program executed, before executing the program. Normally before executing the program we are allocating the memory space for a variables, that is actually known as static memory allocation. Second one is dynamic. Here is an example for static memory allocation. Normally I will declare int variable, so int a. Int a means that allocates 2 bytes of memory space during the compilation. This is normally what we did till now, that is actually the static memory allocation. If you declare any variable in your program, normally that is allocation of memory. If you declare any variables in your program, that is actually known as allocation of memory. So that allocation is known as static allocation. So normally int a, int b, float a, float b, double a, double b, anything, anything if you declared in a program, that is actually static memory allocation. That tells the compiler how many bytes is required. For example, integer variable means 2 bytes. If you declared double means 8 bytes. If it is a float means 4 bytes. If a character means 1 byte. So that is the total bytes required for compilation. Next is dynamic memory allocation. This is important one, dynamic memory allocation. Dynamic memory allocation refers to the process of allocating the memory during the execution of the program or at the runtime. Static means allocating the memory at compilation. Here allocating the memory during execution of a program or at the runtime. When you are going to execute the program, at that time memory is allocated. Memory space allocated with this method is not fixed. You can't say it's a fixed memory. In static, that memory space is fixed. 2 bytes means 2 bytes. If you declare 4 bytes, that is a 4 byte is fixed. But here, not like that. It is not a fixed. It may change. C++ supports dynamic memory allocation and deallocation of object using new and delete keyword. By using the new and delete keyword, is possible to allocate and deallocate the memory. There are two keywords we are using. One is new and one more is delete. Remember, two keywords. New keyword and delete keyword, two keywords are used to allocate and deallocate. So new keyword is used to allocate and delete keyword is used to deallocate the memory using the runtime. These operators allocates the memory for an object from a pool called free space or free store. From a pool, or is free store is also known as, that pool is known as heap memory. There are two memories present. One is heap memory, one more is stack memory. Stack memory, from the stack memory, memory is allocated for static memory allocation. For static memory allocation, data or memory is allocated from stack memory. For dynamic, it is from heap memory, or that is known as free store. From the free store, memory is allocated for the dynamic memory allocation. The new operator called the special function operator new, and delete operator called the special function operator delete. If you use the new and delete keyword, you call the same member functions new and delete. First, we'll move to the new operator. How we can use the new operator in your program? We can allocate storage for a variable while program is running by using the new operator. By using the new operator, it's possible to allocate the storage space for a variable when program is executing. When you are going to execute the program, at that time memory space is allocated by using the new operator. It is used to allocate the memory without having to define variable and then make pointers point to them. So it is without defining the variables we can allocate. Without defining first, directly we can allocate the memory space. The following codes demonstrate how allocation of memory for different variable. Here down you can see the examples. Int p number, pointer p number is equal to new int. So that is, new is the keyword, int type is assigned during the runtime. Second, double pointer dptr, one more variable dptr is equal to new double of 25. See, first one is normal variable, integer variable allocation. Second one is example for array allocation. It is also possible to allocate array during the execution, dynamic allocation of array. Then last one is student sp is equal to new student. If you, so student is a class, or that is an object, sp is object. For that sp object, you can allocate the memory during runtime. The next is the delete operator. The delete operator is used to destroy the variables space which has been created by using the new operator dynamically. The delete operator is mainly used to destroy the memory space allocated by using new operator. By using new operator, if you allocate any memory, by using the new operator, if you allocate any memory that can be deleted or that can be destroyed by using the delete operator. Here is a some example. Use delete operator to free dynamic memory. How you can delete? So here, delete iptr, if it is integer, normal, any variable is there, means you can directly use delete keyword, then iptr pointer name. Then array, if array is there, means delete, then brackets, square brackets or subscript. It's for one dimensional array. If it is two, means two subscripts. Then dptr pointer, sorry, struct, that is for arrays. So array name you should mention. The last one is structure. If it is structure, any structure, either object or structures or class or structures. If it is class, means class name. If it is structure, means structure name. It is a delete operator. Then what is the difference between the static memory allocation and dynamic memory allocation? Static means the memory space is allocated before the execution of the program. It's important one. This may ask for 3 marks or 5 marks in exam. What is the difference between static memory allocation and dynamic memory allocation? Memory space is allocated before the execution of the program. Before executing the program, memory space is allocated, that is static memory allocation. And dynamic means memory space is allocated during the execution of the program. When you are going to execute the program, at that time memory space is allocated, that is dynamic memory allocation. And one more difference is memory space allocated is fixed. In case of static memory allocation, how much memory you allocated, that is fixed for static, and that is not fixed for the dynamic memory allocation. Next one is more memory space is required in case of static memory allocation. More memory space is required in case of static memory allocation, and less memory space is required in case of dynamic memory allocation. In case of dynamic memory allocation, less space is required. In case of static memory allocation, more space is required. And main difference is, in case of static memory allocation, memory allocated from stack area. Remember, I'm not going to explain what is the stack and what is the heap. Normally, in case of static memory allocation, memory is allocated from stack area. In case of dynamic memory allocation, the memory is allocated from heap area. Remember, heap and stack. Stack area for static allocation, dynamic is from heap area. Here we'll move to the next topic, that is free store and memory leak. Free store and memory leak. Free store, it is also known as heap memory. Free store is also known as heap memory, is a pool of memory available to allocated and deallocated storage for the object during the execution of memory. Free store means it's a pool of memory, the pool of free memory that is available to allocate or deallocate. It's possible to allocate or deallocate storage for object during the execution. So if you want to allocate the memory during the runtime, that memory is taken from pool of memory, that is known as free store. From the free store or from the heap memory, the memory is allocated. If the objects that are allocated memory dynamically are not deleted using the delete, the memory block remains occupied even at the end of the program. See, if you allocated the memory using the new keyword, and if you are not going to delete using the delete keyword, remember, first you allocated the memory, for example 2 bytes you allocated for one variable using the new keyword. At the end of the program, you are not going to delete that one by using the delete. That memory remains occupied. So that memory is known as wastage. That is waste of memory. That wastage of memory is known as memory leak. It is not possible to use to any other memories. That memory cannot be used by other. So that situation is actually known as memory leak. Wastage of memory, that is known as memory leak. Next topic here, pointers and structure. What is the relation between pointers and structures? Here one structure definition is given. What you studied in structure last year, same structure definition given. Struct student, one student structure is created. Two elements are there. One is roll number, integer type. One more is float. Float, fees. Fees is a data type, float, and roll number in the form of int. So I create one structure variable, student s. So how we can access the structure elements? S dot roll number, s dot fee. That is structure elements. That is actually structure elements can be accessed by using the dot operator. Dot operator can be used. But one more structure variable is created here, sp. SP is the one more structure variable of pointer type. Of pointer type, is also possible to create a structure variable in the form of pointers. So student pointer SP, and I assign the address of S. Address of S is assigned to SP. So SP is the pointer, S is the normal student variable. So how we can access the data? So if you want to assign the data, SP, that is pointer SP is a variable, then dot operator roll number, I want to assign the roll number as 14. So I assign dot operator, using dot operator, pointer SP is a variable in bracket, dot roll number is equal to 14. So you can also assign the fee, pointer sp dot roll number is equal to, pointer sp dot fee, you can assign the fee 10,000 or 20,000, anything. See above the statement, pointer sp dot roll number, and if we use the pointer in structures, then no need to use the dot operator to access, no need to use the dot operator to access the structure element. Instead of dot operator, we can use a new operator, that is arrow operator. See, if you check your keyboard, in that arrow operator is not there, arrow is not there. So normally you can use minus and less than symbol, angle brackets is are there, so you can use minus and angle brackets for arrow operator. Arrow operator is not there in case of system, so we can use minus and less than symbol or greater than it, that symbol we can use. So here last is the example, you can see sp operator, arrow operator, roll number is equal to 14. This statement and pointer sp dot roll number equal to 14, both also same, but second statement is a better one. It means that sp points to roll number, arrow operator meaning is sp points to roll number. Remember, sp is object or variable pointer that points to the roll number, so we can use sp arrow operator in case of structure. Here last topic, pointer and object, what is the relation between the pointers and object? The pointer pointing to object are referred to as object pointers. Remember, whenever, don't need to see the definition like that, whenever if you created object in the form of pointers, whenever when you are going to create an object, that object if you created in the form of pointers, then that is known as object pointers. How you can declare the object pointers? Here see the one syntax, class name then space pointer then point object name. Remember, class name space pointer symbol then object pointer semicolon. Here class name is the name of the class, object pointer is the point object of the class type, object of the class type. Here you can see the example, employee is the class name, then pointer, then EPTR, then semicolon is there. Remember, then semicolon is there, employee, pointer, EPTR, then semicolon. Here is an example, pointer and object. What is the relation between the pointer and exam? One example here. Here, one class is created with three data members, EMP number, name and salary. Then in public there are two functions, read and display. See, this program just going to read the data and to display the details. It will read the employee number, name and salary, also displays the employee number, name and salary. There is nothing much in this, but you see the main program here, just check out the main part. In main part, first two variables are created. One is employee, one object, one more is pointer object, EP. See, there are two object for the class, one is normal object E, one more is pointer object. So pointer object should be assigned by the address of the same type. So EP is equal to ampersand or address of E. Normally we will say ampersand, or it is address of operator, address operator. So EP is equal to address of E. Address of E is assigned to EP. Then if you want to access the two functions, one is a read, one is a display. If you use a E, we can E dot read, E dot display. Normally we can use E dot read and E dot display, but here it is a pointers. If it is a pointer, we have to use EP arrow or EP points to read arrow operator and EP points to display. EP points to read and EP points to display. These are the two methods to read. Then here employee is an already defined class. When you are accessing the members of the class, an object pointer this arrow operator is used instead of dot operator. Normally, instead of dot operator, we have to use arrow operator. This is a one example for pointers and objects. Here is the last topic of this session, that is this pointer. Every object in C++ has access to its own address through an important pointer called this pointer. This pointer is a pointer that can hold the address of any operator or any object. That is actually the variable. This pointer is a variable. This is a keyword that we can use that will change. For example, if you call the this pointer from object 1, then this pointer data will be object 1. If you call the this pointer by using object 2, then object 2 data will be assigned to the this pointer. Means this pointer does not contain the fixed value. This pointer does not contain any fixed value. If you call by which object, that object data will be assigned to the this pointer. If you call the this pointer by using the one object, that object data will be copied to this pointer. If you going to call the this pointer using another object, that another object data will be copied to the this pointer. So this pointer data will remaining will changing again and again based on the call, which function you are using or which object you are using to call, that object data will be assigned to the this pointer. Here we reach the end of our session today. In this session we discussed about what is static memory allocation and dynamic memory allocation. What is static memory allocation and dynamic memory allocation? Pointer and structures. What is the relation between the pointer and structure? And same, what is the relation between pointers and object? And last topic is this topic, this pointer. So today I will wind up my session. Thank you.